how much water will that soil hold? So look here, and I think Steve's already kind of mentioned this, but a real sandy soil, your intake rate on water is 3/4 to 1 inch per hour. So if you're designing a system, this type of system here would be more like a sprinkler system, something that's throwing out a large quantity of water. Compared to, let's look at the silty loam, 1/4 to 4/10 of an inch per hour, this is where drip or micro-irrigation can definitely come in, because you're putting out a little bit of water over a period of time, and you're not getting it too much. If you're putting a big sprinkler on this loam soil, and it's only taking up 1/10 of an inch per hour, what's going to happen if you're putting on big amounts of water? It's going to puddle, right? It's going to sit there, and you're kind of wasting that water. So this here, knowing your soil, will definitely help you design your system and know what kind of system you want to put in. Another thing that's really important is to know what your crops require. And I'm just going to mention a little bit on fruits here. If you got apples, general recommendations about 20 to 45 gallons per day. But if you're growing pears out there, look at pears, 5 to 8 gallons per week. So there's a huge difference there. So that might be important in helping you do your scheduling or your design. Peaches, nectarines, look, as they age, the water amounts go up. 5 year old on up on peaches, be using 30 gallons per day. So you need to know that in advance whenever you're designing your system. Don't design it to work for this 1 or 2 years. Make sure you design it where the trees are mature and getting what they need. I see a lot of people writing down, so I'm going to leave it there for a second. Another important thing is to understand the root depth of your crop. Steve mentioned on some of the vegetable crops, 6-8 inches. But what do you think the fruit or the root depth is on, say, like an apple? Anybody want to guess? Think it's 12 inches, 24 inches, 6 foot? Think it's down 6 foot? Probably not. Most of your roots is going to be in apples, probably in the top 2 foot of the soil. Might be down 3 foot depending on the root stock. Pears, probably down close to 3 foot, 24 inches to 36 inches. Peaches, probably in the top foot, 12 inches to 18 inches of the soil. That's where most of your root system is going to be. Let's talk about pecans. What's the root depth on a pecan? Is that right? Yeah. Would you believe, even though a big, massive tree that could be 100, maybe even 200 foot tall, 90% of your root system's in the top 36 inches of the soil? So this really plays into your irrigation scheduling. You don't want to water past that 36 inches because you're just wasting your water. Again, as the tree ages or grows, your water amounts go up. And look here, a 60 foot tall tree, usually 50 years old or older, require up to 150 gallons per day. It's a lot of water, right? So one thing, whenever you're thinking about your system, think about your water requirements. And we probably should have had this earlier, but we're going to talk about it. Let's say on pecans, they generally require about 54 inches of water per year. So if you have 20 acres that you're planting, how much water do you think you need to supply that 20 acres with all the water it needs? Well, if you do the calculations, there's a little over 27,000 gallons per acre inch. On that 20 acres, that's 29 million gallons of water you need. So if you were doing this buying city water or rural water, this gets pretty expensive, right? And there's been people that's tried this, and they did not work out to see how much water they need. So make sure that your system can supply what you need. We get a lot of questions. Oh, I got this nice pond out there. can I irrigate out of it? Well, is your pond big enough? How many trees are you going to plant? So let's look. If you have about an acre pond, let's assume that its average depth is 7 foot. So you got a little over 1.7 million gallons of water in that pond. But is all that water available to you? No. So let's just kind of assume 66% utilization. So how much water can, or how much water to, how much water do you have to irrigate? Whoops, sorry, I messed up. You have about 1 acre of water there to irrigate. So you can plant about an acre worth of crops to irrigate out of that acre pond. And this is just a kind of an assumption of what you can pull out of that pond. What happens to that pond during the drought? It goes down. What happens if you want to fish in that pond? You better have 7 foot of water or your fish won't survive. So you need to kind of think about all those before you use a pond as a source for your irrigation. Oh, yeah. They just won't be there very long. All right, to schedule your irrigation for especially for tree crops or vegetables, this is really used for tree crops, is your ET. How much is evaporating through that tree? And you can go to the Oklahoma Mesonet site. There's a station within every county, and you can find one close to you, and you can click on that, and there's a irrigation scheduling section. And they have one for pecans. They have one, I think they have one for vegetables, for lawns. And you can see exactly how much is the atmosphere is pulling away from the crops. And as much as the atmosphere is pulling away, that's how much you need to be putting back. Another way you can do is the soil moisture sensors to see how much moisture is actually in the soil. And another is the field test. If you're doing the field test on a tree crop, don't go down just 6 inches. You might need to dig down about a foot to get to that soil where that root system is going to be at. All right, this is the ET for the Noble Foundation Orchard up by Medill. And I just pulled this off the other day. And the one thing you want to keep in mind is it runs kind of backwards here. So here was when I downloaded it on the 15th. And you see I've got it down to March the 27th. But it's going to tell you what your ET each day is, a running total of your ET, what your rainfall is, and accumulated rainfall, and then it's going to tell you your water balance. So looking at this, you kind of see there's 4 days here we had negative water balance. Think that's enough to worry about irrigating? Not really. 0.13 inches is enough for me to go out and turn on the system. For these trees in this orchard, I'll probably wait until it gets close to an inch. And that way I can run my system, wet the surface, get the water moving into the root zone. If I went out and every time it got close to this and turned it on, I'd probably be watering the grass, really not watering the roots of the trees. So, but this is very useful, very, very useful to know what's going on in that situation, in that orchard. They actually do, yes, sir. I can't recall exactly what depths they're in, but they do have, I think, two sets, and it's under bare ground and under sod, and so you can kind of see what the difference is. The thing to remember about the Mesonet station, it only tells you what's going on at that exact site. We're lucky at our orchard, we got the Mesonet station sitting right next to the field. And so we can really correlate what's going on. But if you're 10 miles or 20 miles away from the Mesonet station, your situation might be totally different. Again, I like to use these some kind of soil probe to know exactly what's going on. The only difference with what Steve was telling you is if you're growing trees, you want to put it lower down to where that root zone is. So really, I prefer to start even with a peach tree that's not real deep rooted, go down to about 12 inches and then maybe down to 24. If you're doing pecans or pears, you might even go down 36, but my experience is you don't get a lot of change in that 36 inch profile. Another thing, it's really hard to get it down to 36 inches without breaking them. So, but you'll definitely see a change between 12 inches and 24 inches. And that's 24 inches is going to be right in the heart of your root system. So if you see this start to drop off, then you know you definitely have to irrigate. And on the 12 inch, you're at the kind of the top of the root system, so you can let it get a little drier and then start irrigating. So you can kind of play with these and fine-tune your irrigation system.